Hey, this is Mark from Mobile Diesel. I thought I should make another video. I showed you in the first video how to find the error codes, but this guy, this video I want to show the digital input test. This is also in the data mode and not the calibration mode. But let me show you how to get to it. So first off, let's turn her on. I'm going to start her up. First thing we gotta do is get out of calibration mode and into data mode. So I'm gonna hold this guy down. Now we're into data mode. This is hydraulic trigger. It's one. That is temperature. So we're at 1,000. I mean RPM. 1,210 RPM. 82 degree coolant temperature. 45 degree. Celsius, I mean, not Fahrenheit. So both of those, 80 Celsius and 45 Celsius. This is hydraulic temp. I believe the next is airco. This is digital analog, which is nothing. Air codes, we have zero. Now this guy here is digital input test. There's a whole slew. I have a book here. The digital input. These are all different inputs, and we have on or off for them, right? So what you gotta do is now go from, instead of travel speed, we gotta go to, I'm sorry, alarm cancel, and now press work instead. And this is digital input one. This is the harness code. Okay, so we got an off for travel pressure switch. We're just gonna go through all of them here. Three is attachment pressure, and that is off. Four is engine oil pressure switch, which is on because the motor's running. Five, six, and seven are spares. And then eight is the low idle switch. Let me turn down the idle. Should go on. Don't ask me why it doesn't. There's a few that aren't going on that I'm suspicious of. This is to be continued because I think we're having an issue with something else, so I'm wondering if that's an issue. But anyways, let's keep going here. Number nine, boom raise pressure. So let's raise the boom. Boom. Okay, and that should go on, but it's not. Now I'm dead blowing it, it's going on. And I think this thing should go on earlier. Till it dead blows. And then it finally kicks on. But not. It should go on when the bucket goes up, right? And it's not. Well, I'm spending so much time on this, I'll show you in a second. Okay, then it goes from numbers to letters. So let's go to the letters. A is governor actuator backup. B is pump backup switch. And I think that's pertinent to a problem we're having. The switch, I believe, is broken. C is the spare. his starter switch, so we're in the on position. It's running. That's correct. E is implement swing pressure. So that's the moving left and right, right? So if I swing, so it goes on with the bucket. It goes on when I lift. And it goes on when I swing. So I'm swinging now. Going on much more so when I'm lifting, much more sensitive than the boom lift switch, the boom brake switch, which is 9. All of this is pertinent. So what I'm getting at is the track's not moving, and I think there's internal leakage. That's kind of where I'm going with this. This is kind of how you could use it to diagnose. F is alternator, that one's on. H, J, L, N, and P are all spares. And we're back in the beginning. This is a harness code 012. Alright, so we go to track. The left track doesn't work. Oh, actually, travel pressure. Oh, I gotta go around the horn here. All the way to 2. Okay, so travel pressure. The right track is working. Occasionally this will go on, but most of the time, even if I do the right track, it'll stay off. Oh, I switched on for a moment there. But it's not anymore. And this guy, the left track's not working at all. So I think the monitor block for these switches are in the same general area, and there's a problem with that block. There's internal leakage in that block, and that's kind of where I'm going with this. But now you know how to get into this mode. Once again, hold down the alarm cancel. We can hold it down and get back into calibration. Get back in there for you. One last time. I think 5 people around the world are going to watch this video. It's so specific, but I was pulling my hair out trying to figure it out, so I wanted to share it. Alright, so we're in the data mode. We're going to cycle through PM, temperature for antifreeze. Then we have temperature for hydraulic fluid, then analog digital, then air, and finally we're digital input test, and then from there, still using alarm cancel, but we can cycle through all the different digital inputs. Okay? All 5 of you around planet Earth, you're welcome.